observability is the right answer for the evolution and the journey that SolarWinds has been taking clients on.
Being able to see all that information in one pane of glass, being able to organize and maintain that, it's a really simple product.
Observability gives a customer everything they could possibly want as far as visibility of their key infrastructure.
We're in 60 different countries. We have 260 different sites with a whole collection of equipment, and SolarWinds lets us keep track of it.
It's just the best platform there is.
I'm Crystal Taylor.
And I'm Josh Stagerberg.
And we're super excited today to announce a new SolarWinds offering, SolarWinds Observability.
Yeah, we're here today to talk about our new software as a service offering, SolarWinds Observability.
Well, that sounds exciting and new and different. So what can you tell me about it?
With SolarWinds Observability, we took an approach that said, how are we going to deliver value to DevOps users who are delivering modern applications on modern infrastructure within their businesses? And in that context, we came at it from, let's support natively hyperscalers, so like Amazon or Azure. We said, let's support native basic APM capabilities like code instrumentation. Let's support log tailing, even database capabilities, right? So there's a lot in here, and we're going to unpack a lot of that through the things that I show you today.
That's very exciting. So you mentioned a couple of cloud platforms, which is very exciting. Everyone's sort of on a journey to the cloud. They're either partially there, they're using multiple different cloud vendors, or, you know, in some rare cases, they're still completely on premises. So, why don't you walk us through a little bit about that? How does that work?
Sure. So from the first time you log into SolarWinds Observability, you'll have a simple setup screen that looks like this. The AWS CloudWatch integration is something that you can set up with just a few clicks by clicking on AWS, putting in a display name, and getting your tag from AWS, and then hitting setup using CloudFormation. Similarly, for Azure, you can do a very quick setup that allows you to quickly get your Azure and AWS environments into the system. Now, what that looks like, if we dig down, is we can go down to our metrics, right? And we can see, for instance, all of the AWS CloudWatch metrics that you can collect in sort of an infinite scroll. And of course, you can search for the ones that are most important to you very quickly from the top menu. So again, just immediate, fast, get your data in, start seeing stuff in a single pane of glass.
We love immediate results, quick and easy at SolarWinds. And I personally am very excited for the clean and easy to use interface. I think that's always a good move. What do we expect for multi-cloud strategy? We have two now. Are there plans for the future to add more?
Yeah, so in the future, we'll probably be adding hyperscalers like GCP and maybe even additional ones. In the meantime, we've also got the capability to look at your private cloud infrastructure as well and be able to bring that into our single pane of glass. So when I show you, for instance, our home screen, what we're looking at is a combination of all of the hosts and the database infrastructure and services and websites across all our different environments, including our multiple clouds, right? Which gives you a real bird's eye view of what's going on in your environment.
Awesome. Helping to make some connections between all of those things as we have to do manually now. Mm-hmm. What does that look like for thresholds and kind of alerting and all of that? If we have all of it in one place, does that mean that we also have the capability to do all of that in one place? We don't really have to go to all these different places to get those things done?
Yeah. So our alerting is a specific section in our environment where you can create and set up alerting based on various triggers, including and set severity types and sort of what the alerts do, right? One of the cool things about this is if we were to go and create an alert, right, we can quickly decide whether this is a critical or a warning or an informational alert, and then we can step through a simple wizard to build out conditions and the notification settings. And when we do that, right, let's say this alert is going to be called SolarWinds demo alert, right? And we'll click next. We can set this alert based on metrics we collect or even log data. And then we can say simply from a dropdown, we can say this is a website alert, right? And it's scoped by specific websites, and we can set up conditions, tags, triggers, right? And all this in the single wizard, and then we show the summary. Now, one thing that I want to address each time is, well, but I don't want yet another alerting system, right? So if you're using, whether you're using Slack or whether you're using Teams, if I go to notification services, you can see the integrations that we have built in out of the box, things like Slack, Teams, Opsgenie, PagerDuty, right? And we're consistently adding more here so that you're not actually having to decide where you want this data, but it's coming into the system that you want it to.
Yeah, that's really exciting. I also see there that you've got just like a bog standard webhook integration, which is great because you can, you know, all kinds of alternative products of whatever you might be using. If you're not using one of the mainstream ones, you still have options. You can set up a webhook. So that's very exciting.
Yeah, webhooks also let us create tickets in various ITSM systems, including our own, right? But also if you use a third-party system.
Awesome. I think everyone would be excited if they don't have to set up a new ITSM if they got a new new software set up. So you mentioned while we were in the alerting thing, you showed that we can alert off of metrics, but also off of logs. So what does that look like in SolarWinds Observability?
So with SolarWinds Observability, we'll be able to pull logs from all your various data sources, whether they're databases, servers, programs, applications, and you'll be able to tail them in a single pane of glass. What that means is not only will you see the logs coming in, but you'll be able to search based on time, tag, program, or even query syntax. And of course, SolarWinds Observability supports a flexible retention period for logs depending on your needs as well.
That was going to be my next question. So it does live and historical query.
Yeah. So the live tail is really great for when you're troubleshooting an application that you've just pushed into production or when you're looking into an issue. And then historical is really great when you come back from that weekend trip and you say, what happened this weekend, right? So both of those use cases are really well supported here in the tool.
Okay, so we've talked about quite a few things. And what does the licensing look like for this? Everyone's going to be asking, what does the licensing look like? So let's talk a little bit about that. Is it like a per seat? Is it per device? Is it per log metric? Is it per metric? How does that work?
Yeah, so we tried to make the licensing really straightforward depending on what your needs are, right? So if you need logs for a certain period of time, we can provide that. If you need digital experience monitoring type checks, right? So like uptime, for example, you can get those in a cost metric that makes sense, right? But what we really wanted to avoid was charging you for the number of people that use the system, right? So I think the way to think of a system like this is that the more people that have access to it, the more powerful you're going to be able to be in terms of communicating, having people have that shared source of truth, really be able to troubleshoot and quickly get on the same page rather than sort of having disagreements on calls. I'm looking at this tool, I'm looking at that tool, right?
Yeah.
So we really sort of went down that path, right? How do we make it so that we're charging you meaningfully for the types of things that you want and making sure that you can leverage it across your entire organization.
That sounds really good. So collaboration and communication are really important these days, especially with kind of distributed workforces, distributed customers. So how are we kind of handling that with the observability?
Yeah, so when we thought about imagining digital experience monitoring in SolarWinds Observability, we weren't starting from scratch. Right. So our Pingdom product is a sort of well-established digital experience monitoring tool, combining things like uptime checks, synthetic monitoring, real user monitoring, right? And we have brought that goodness over to SolarWinds Observability. If you take a look at my screen here, what I'm showing you is where we've brought up our first set of probes in SolarWinds Observability, and more coming as time goes on. And from each of these places, you can run each of these style of checks. So that way, you don't have to have a presence in, you don't have to host your website in Europe in order to make sure that it's available to European customers, for example, or European employees. And then, additionally, when you look at our digital experience monitoring section of the tool, you can see at a glance how many of your websites are up, how many of your websites are in a good state, right? What your availability looks like. So we're starting to show you a real bird's eye view of what your environment looks like from a digital experience monitoring perspective, which we think really delivers on that value.
What would you say to those of our potential users, our DevOps customers, what they can do about open telemetry? telemetry. I know that's a really big deal right now. Everyone's very excited about it, and there's a lot of users for that space. So what do we do for open telemetry?
Yeah, so we took the approach with SolarWinds Observability that we would make open telemetry the standard endpoint for ingest into the system. And what that means is our customers can use any open telemetry agents that they've already got in their environment, as well as if they'd like to use open telemetry agents that are managed by our system. You can see here we have our agent management framework where you can actually see what agents are deployed where, whether they are what versions they are, when they were last seen. You can turn on automatic updates, right? So again, we have a unified agent management framework that lets you understand what's going on with the agents in your environment. But I want to emphasize the agents themselves that we're providing are open telemetry agents, right?
Okay.
So our endpoint really is open telemetry, and you can roll your own if you like as well.
Awesome. So that means if I already have an open telemetry agent that I like, I don't have to download and install a new agent. I can just send the data to SolarWinds Observability.
Exactly.
All right. So we've talked a lot about the ways that you can get data in here. So let's talk about correlation, because I think that's going to be really important. Right now, there's a lot of manual work involved in correlating data, right? You know what parts of your app are connected to what parts and what you need to look to, but should you have to do that manually?
So in SolarWinds Observability, we thought we'd automate all that for you.
Yes.
So whether we're getting data from our open telemetry agents or whether we're using that open telemetry code instrumentation to understand what's going on in the actual application, whether we're looking at the database queries, we'll be able to pull all that together in our unified platform here and show you all of these relationships that we are able to infer. And here on the screen, I've got a service that's running, and I can show you, if I scroll down, the topology map. These are all inferred connections for this service, and this service being like a service that a customer has built to run in their cloud.
That's very exciting. So, you know, everything in one place, and, you know, color coding, I assume is going to be status coding?
Yeah. So the color coding that you're seeing here is based on our health score. And when we talk about health score, we talk about a derived metric that you can't just pull off of a system. You can't say service or application or cloud, what is your health, right? And so what we're doing is we're using our machine learning technology that we built into the platform to come up with a health score from everything from a individual device all the way up to a complex multi-cloud service. And then we're leveraging that throughout the system, whether it's in visuals like this, or alerting, or dashboards, right? So that you have a metric that you can see consistently across every level of your application.
Awesome. At a glance, knowing how it's doing. That's the key to making it observable.
Yeah, especially when a server or a Kubernetes container, for example, might be down or might have its system, its CPU pegged, but it's not affecting your application, right? You need health score at these different levels to understand what's really going on.
Absolutely. Well, this is a great use case. It's another conversation for an application that might be hosted on the web. And we've talked a lot about web stuff. I don't want to leave behind our database friends. So talk to me a little bit about what database is playing in here.
So connecting to database is also a key value prop, like you mentioned. And what we're able to do from a service here is see what databases are associated with that service, but artifacts like how much time is being consumed by database queries. But we can go a step deeper. We can go into traces. Now, these are APM traces, and these traces can actually connect all the way through into the database. So what that looks like, when I click on a trace, I can actually see the raw data and the query coming into the database, as well as all of the information that I need in order to hit root cause. For instance, what the database was, what actual trace span it was, what the actual amount of seconds it took for that specific database call. And in the future, we'll go a step further and automate that root cause analysis directly and show it up to the user.
Wow, you're getting me very excited. I love automation. The more we can automate, the less work our end users have to do.
Very true.
as you know, in the IT world, we have a big problem with too many notifications. It's so much noise that we can't figure out what's actually going wrong. And a lot of times that leads to extended periods of time trying to fix problems like performance degradation that our users are seeing. But we kind of want to get ahead of that. So what can we do about that?
So, for example, you might set up an alert condition on a trace, right? So in this case, let's take an example where I have a service that I built, and what the service is returning a 500 error, right? Mm-hmm. So this is clearly an alert based on something where I'm getting a no response, yeah. Right? And in this context, inside SWO, under my service, I can look at traces, and I can see this status 500 error is coming back. So if I click on details to understand what's going on, I can see very quickly that this 500 error is actually a PHP parse error, and I can go back and look at the timestamp of when this is occurring, right? And when I see that, I say, oh, well, that's related to a software push we just made. Let's go ahead and roll that software push back. Right? So very quickly, understanding what's going on in my environment in a way that impacts users based on an alert that's meaningful to me. And the last thing you do is, before you create a group, is select whether you want to use the health as an average, a worst case, or a best case for that group.
Well, what does that mean?
Well, so what? Think of a situation where you have six servers behind a load balancer, and you're not going to interrupt your weekend with your family to if one of them or two of them are down, right? Okay. You might select average. But think about a group of servers and application that support your critical business needs that say if any of these things are down, it might have dire consequences to your business, right? You might say, I want this group's health to reflect the worst score of anything in this group.
Right.
Right? So there's different reasons to choose them, but we make this flexibility because we envision people being able to provide themselves with the most meaningful alerts at the right time in the group that they want.
So you've told us a lot today about the new product, right? You've told us about the different types of data we can pull in, how it looks in the platform, the types of customizations we can do, the different ways we can do alerting, all kinds of things. So what makes SolarWinds Observability different and special?
Yeah, so we talked about digital experience monitoring. We talked about application performance monitoring. We talked about network and infrastructure capabilities. We talked about hyperscalers and cloud. We talked about database. We talked about log management, right? There's a lot of pieces here. Pulling them together, what you get is an alert that fires against your digital experience monitor that triggers a trace that associates the relevant log data that runs all the way through into the database so that you can understand no matter where the issue is, exactly where the root cause of the problem is in your application or your service as quickly as possible in a single pane of glass using SolarWinds Observability, which means that you can maintain those aggressive SLO and SLA targets that you're tasked with as a DevOps engineer, as a developer, as an IT pro.
Well, we love to hear it. Any way you can pinpoint a problem faster to resolve it faster is always better in everyone's books. I mean, in not just, you know, in a I want to move on with my day situation, but also, I mean, as a business service, it's critical to keep things up and running as fast as possible. I mentioned it earlier, but patience is out the window. So it's definitely improvement on everything that I've seen so far to see that we can get in there and see it right away and correlate different types of data together and find the problem faster.
And we are really excited to share SolarWinds Observability with you starting today.